Hey everybody, welcome back to A Better Computer. My name is Matt, and today I wanted to take a quick look at a bunch of little things and some bigger things that have really stood out to me in 2024 as products that I just really enjoy. So some of this is software, some of it's hardware, but all of it will be techie in some way. So let's just jump into it. I'm going to try to go very, very quickly over each one and hopefully try to sell it to you in like 30 seconds. So the first is a keyboard from Keychron. This is from their Lemokey line. This is the L4 keyboard. This was provided to me for review. But I'm very happy to say this is without a doubt the best Keychron family keyboard I've ever used. I've used the Q1 before. I really liked that for a long time, but then my standards increased for keyboards and it wasn't quite up to snuff. I really like the Lemokey. It feels fantastic. It is a very, very, very good feeling keyboard. It sounds very good. I'll do a sound test in a second here to let you see kind of how it sounds. But I love the connectivity options. You can use a wired connection over USB-C. You can use Bluetooth with up to three different devices, and it comes with a dongle. And there's this cool little thing on the back here that is kind of hard to find. You may not find it right away, but the little dongle sits back here. It's USB-A, not USB-C. USB-C would be kind of nice for this as well. But yeah, the Lemokey line, the L4 specifically, I fully endorse this keyboard. I think it's awesome. Now, while I am using the Lemokey right now as my keyboard, it's not the absolute best typing experience I've ever had. That belongs to this, the Mode Envoy, which is an absolutely delightful keyboard to type on. It is absolutely the best. If I have to type for a long time, this is the keyboard I want to use because it is so sublime. It feels so good. It looks so good. I've got kind of the green one with the copper accents. I assembled it myself, which just attaches me even more to it emotionally. But there is no better typing experience that I've ever felt than using this keyboard. The one big downside is it's only a wired connection. You can only connect over USB-C. There's no wireless, which for me is frustrating when I'm switching between computers all day long. I have a gaming PC, a home Mac, and a work Mac. So three computers on my desk that I'm switching between. That's what makes this more convenient for me. But for just pure typing experience, and if I'm not switching between devices or if I have an easy way to switch the wire, the Mode Envoy is sublime. Before I move off keyboards, this is just an honorable mention. This is the Keychron K3 Max. It's Keychron's, I think, newest low-profile mechanical keyboard. I was also provided this one from Keychron to review, and I think it's fine. I don't think it's astounding. I think for low-profile keyboards I've used, I like the low-free flow a little better than this. I think the keys feel better. I think it looks a little better than this. But I do like this a lot better than the Logitech MX Mechanical. I think that one, I don't know. I know people like it. I don't like that keyboard. I think this sits in the middle and is readily available. One of the nice things about Keychron is that their stuff is just available and you can buy it and have it shipped right away. Not always the case in the keyboard world. So I think that keyboard's fine, but it's not the one for me. Now let's move off keyboards. This isn't a keyboard video. The other thing I want to call out is the M4 iPad Pro, which I really, really, really like. It's a fantastic iPad. It's incredibly fast. It is incredibly reliable. The OLED screen looks fantastic. This is my preferred place to do photo editing now because I think it's the best display in my life. It is just a fantastic device, and if you like the iPad, if you like iPad OS, there's no better product out there. Obviously, it's the best iPad. Another thing to call out is the new Magic Keyboard, which is a notable improvement. I made a video about this, but this is a notably better keyboard than the Magic Keyboard for the original iPad Pro that came out in 2020. So definitely an improvement there. The metal design, it really makes it feel more like a full-on laptop. Now, this product came out in 2022, I think, but It's still totally awesome, and that's the M2 MacBook Pro. This is the M2 Pro model. I think this is just a workhorse computer. I have no desire to get one of the new M4s because my M2 Pro is still crushing it. It's doing an amazing job doing video editing. This is a 4K video I'm editing on that computer, and I'm going to have no issues at all. It's going to be just awesome. So I think that was the right time to buy into that generation of product. I think the M1s were awesome. I think the M2s, especially the M2 Pro, was a fantastic jump. That was very close to the M2 Max at that year. And then the M3, they kind of made the Pro less good. The M4 kind of bounced back. But anyway, there's no bad Apple Silicon Max, but I think this one's a really good one. I'm very happy I have it in my life. Then I wanted to call out Obsidian. Obsidian is just such a cool app. I've made plenty of videos about it already, but the general idea is that Obsidian is an app. It's a note-taking app. It's a writing app. It's for text things, basically. But it all is just an interface on top of a folder full of files. And you own those files. You own those folders. You can do whatever you want with them. I sync it over iCloud. I don't even have to pay for additional syncing for it. And it just works great. I really enjoy having it. I manage my YouTube channel from here. I save highlights from things I read that I want to remember from here. I do my link blogging. That all kicks off here from those highlights. I write show notes for my podcast, Comfort Zone, with Chris Lawley and Neilion. We do that all collaboratively in Obsidian. It is a fantastic all-star app and completely free. The next thing I have to call out is the Synology. Synology, I have the DS923 Plus, I think. This was provided to me by Synology for review. I did a video on this already. Again, links to all these products, all these other videos in the show notes or in the description. But the Synology has just really been an unbelievable addition to my workflow. It lets me archive all of my old YouTube projects, which is a big deal for me. I need to have storage for those, and that's very, very useful. It lets me have a Plex server running that's letting me stream videos that I have just downloaded from wherever that I'm able to watch just on my TV. I really enjoy that. An example is I pay for the Digital Foundry Patreon, which gives me access to download high quality versions of their videos. And I tend to watch those on Plex hosted on my Synology rather than on YouTube because the compression is less. And I just like having a backup of those. So I really, really, really love the Synology. I should have gotten one of these years ago, and I'm very thankful to Synology for providing it. I wouldn't be saying nice things if I didn't actually like it. So yeah, enjoy this product. I also wanted to shout out Mastodon and Bluesky, which are, I'm just happy they are available and around for people who wanted to still do text-based social media, but didn't want to use Twitter anymore, and Threads isn't really resonating with them. I think they're fun. I think they're quirky. I think that they're obviously not for everybody, especially Mastodon is more for a niche group, it seems. But I'm happy they're there, and some of my most enjoyable social experiences on the web happen on those platforms. There's apps built on top of these. I really love Ivory on macOS, iOS, iPadOS for using Mastodon. I also love Mona for using Mastodon. There's plenty of other apps that do that. And Bluesky, just because it's been the hot new thing lately. Some developers are starting to work on that, but I really enjoy having Bluesky as well. I like having these alternatives that I can jump into since Twitter was no longer a place I personally wanted to be. Now let's talk daily games. Puzzmo is my favorite place to play daily games. They have pile-up poker, which I really, really enjoy. I've got well over 100-day streak going on that. They've got a crossword that I think is really fun and just a little quirkier than your average crossword puzzles out there. They have this new weather kind of memory game that's really fun. There's so many good games on this thing, and I paid like $50 for a lifetime subscription to it. You can play it for free as well, but I really love Puzzmo. Another daily game that you may not know about is Lex.Games. That's from Lex Friedman. Not that Lex Friedman, the other Lex Friedman. And it's just a really fun game with more word-based games. So there's one called Connections, which is like the New York Times' Connections game, but just a little different. I think a little better. I find them a little more fun and quirky. It also has one called Lexicogs, where you have to kind of like, you have these tiles, you make words out of them. They have crosswords as well. I don't do the crosswords there as option, but those first two games, or as often, those first two games though are just fantastic, and I really enjoy those. And then what am I going to do? Not mention Things. Things is fantastic. Things is the perfect balance of simple when I just have very simple needs for my task management, and it scales up to being more complex when I need that. And I find personally, my productivity needs, my task manager needs fluctuate. Sometimes I want to be really in the weeds. I want it to be more of a second brain, that kind of second brain idea where everything gets dumped into there. And other times I don't feel I need that. And I just need it for the random reminder to like take out the trash or do the dishes or something. And it's good for both of those. I think it scales really nicely. And the app is just wonderfully made and a delight to use. It syncs beautifully. You guys don't need me to tell you any more about things. I think it's awesome. I also want to be thankful for Vivaldi, which is my current default browser on my Mac. And I've been using Arc for the past like 2 years, and so this is potentially a notable change. I will do a video in the near future, hopefully, on why Vivaldi is awesome and why I've switched to it, because, yeah, I'm quite happy with it and I'm using it as we speak. Now let's move back to the desk for a couple things. My Thunderbolt dock from OWC. This is a Thunderbolt 4 dock. It is utterly fantastic and is the heart of my desk that makes everything work. I mentioned earlier I have multiple computers. I am able to basically take one Thunderbolt cable and move that between whatever computer I'm using to connect my Ethernet connection, to connect my display, to connect my sound system, to connect my speakers, to connect my mouse, my wired keyboard, probably more, my capture card. All of these things run through this one dock, and it's just one Thunderbolt cable. I move from one computer to the next, and everything just connects. It's fantastic. It works with the iPad, too. The iPad Pros, anything with the USB-C, or sorry, an M1, I think, or better, will have Thunderbolt, and your webcam works through there. Like, it's awesome. I really love this Thunderbolt dock. My desk would not be possible without this dock. The other thing over here is the mouse I'm using right now. This is the Logitech MX Master 3S. Tell me if you've heard this one before, but I really do like this mouse. The killer features for me are being able to pair easily with three computers. I did mention I switch computers quite often. I love the scrolling on this. It's the best scroll wheel on any mouse I've ever used. And the killer thing for me as a content creator, I guess, who does screen share stuff and is using my computer, silent clicks. Silent clicks are wonderful for me, and I cannot go back. I really don't see myself ever using a mouse again that makes very audible clicks because they're very distracting. You can hear them on the mic, and silent clicks are awesome. And then there's my display. It's the Sony INZONE M9 display. It's a 27-inch 4K 144Hz variable rate display. It's awesome. It's technically HDR. I think it's HDR 600, which isn't incredible, but it's better than most displays. It's better than the studio display in terms of peak brightness. And yeah, it is just a really great display, especially for the cost. I think it was $900 new when I got it, and they have a replacement out for it now, so you can probably get it on clearance or used for much less than that. And it's just an awesome mix of features. Like I said, 4K, 144Hz, variable refresh. These are all lovely things that I want. And it has four separate inputs you can use. So two HDMI, one DisplayPort, and one USB-C. The USB-C is a kind of a DisplayPort alt mode, which basically means it can still do the high refresh, HDR, all that stuff. And so that's what I'm using with my Macs and my Thunderbolt dock. Works wonderfully. Every other display I look at either doesn't have high refresh, doesn't have 4K, maybe it's only 1440p, it has fewer inputs on the back. Like, this is just the perfect monitor for me. And again, I mentioned that there's a replacement out there from Sony, there's a new model. I'm not tempted by it because it doesn't have the inputs that I want. And yeah, that's a bummer. So really, really love this keyboard, or not this keyboard, this display. If you can get it on sale, on clearance, I think it's a really great deal. Then I wanted to call out the iPhone 15 Pro. Now, the 16 Pro came out this year, and it is my daily driver, but the iPhone 15 Pro, I think, held up really, really well. The 15 Pro didn't have enough battery life for me, so I went with the 15 Pro Max, which I then sold to get the 16. But anyway, I still have the 15 Pro here, and this is just an all-star iPhone. I still think it's one of the best iPhone generations ever that you could have bought in on, and it's just fantastic. It's super quick. It has the new titanium design, which I think is the best iPhone design since, oh, geez, the iPhone 5? It's been a long time. I think it's really, really one of the best. It's just a fantastic phone, and I think if you bought it last year, you would be totally happy with it. The battery life on the 16 Pro is the big thing for me that I like more. It is noticeably better, but the lack of a camera control on the 15 Pro, I honestly don't mind. I liked the button at first, and now I just kind of, I would say I do use it sometimes, but I'm more annoyed that my case has a hole in the side of it for that and makes it feel kind of weird than the amount of time that I use it. So yeah, kind of a bummer there, but the 15 Pro, all-star iPhone. Then I got to talk about the Kindle Paperwhite. I talked about this on my podcast, Comfort Zone, a few weeks ago, and I really like it. It's really worked out well for me. I've gone on a couple trips with it, and it's great to read on the plane. I'm not someone who likes to watch movies on a plane or TV. I like to read, and I used to not have a great way to do that. I would use my phone, and that was fine, but it was kind of annoying. This is great to read on the plane. I don't have to worry about battery life. It's really, really small. And yeah, it's just fantastic. The thing that I really love about it is that it syncs with Audible. So I sometimes it's convenient for me to read, and I'll do that on this. And sometimes it's convenient for me to listen, and so I'll listen to Audible, and those will sync if you own the book on both platforms. Sometimes you get a discount for if you already own it on the Kindle, maybe you'll get a discount on the audiobook or vice versa. It's just really nice. I know I'm kind of bought into Audible's ecosystem by doing this. I could get like a Kobo and have more freedom, but the convenience for me for the number of books I read is really, really nice. I also have this. This is the Analogue Pocket, and it is basically a device for playing old Game Boy games. It does more than that, but in general, that's the purpose of it. On the back here, you can plug in your old games. This is my Golden Sun, my personal Golden Sun cartridge from like 2002, 2003, whenever this came out. You plug it in and you can play that old game. You are literally playing that cartridge. It's not emulating it. It's fantastic. The moment that I plugged this in and picked up my save from 20 years ago was just a magical moment, and I really love the Pocket. It's incredibly well made. It's very comfortable to use. The screen is high quality. The battery lasts. It charges over USB-C. It's just a fantastic device and one that I'm super glad that I purchased. I really love it. And yeah, I just love the ability to play my old games on new hardware because I like playing old games, but sometimes you use those old, especially those handhelds, and you're like, oh boy, this isn't as nice as I remembered. The DS is definitely one of those for me where those screens are tough to look at today. But a Game Boy style device with a modern screen, that's pretty great. And finally, I wanted to call out CleanShot X, which is, full disclosure, I have worked with them for a number of years now making their release notes videos. So whenever they have a new version come out, they work with me to make a video walking through the new features. But they don't pay to do any sponsorship anywhere else. And I still use them and love them and talk about them on this channel because I think it's the best app for taking screenshots and recording your screen on the Mac. It is spectacular. And full disclosure, I have been reached out to by other screenshotting and screen recording apps on the Mac to do similar things with them. And I've turned them down because CleanShot is just the best. Links to more details on why I like CleanShot in the description. But let's just say, I am someone who cares passionately about taking good screenshots and having good screen recordings, and there's nothing better than CleanShot X, in my opinion. So that is it for me today. Thank you so much for watching. Hopefully, this gave you an idea for some things that are cool, some things you might want to check out. It's Black Friday. Maybe some of these are on sale. I know the Synologies are on sale right now. Presumably, some other things are, maybe some of the apps, but check the description. I'll try to keep that up to date this week. And yeah, thank you so much for watching. Bye-bye.